Hello children, in the previous session we understood that sound is a form of wave and sound is produced when the object vibrates. Sound is produced by the vibration of the objects. What is vibration means? The to and fro or the back and forth motion of the objects are called vibrations, and sound travels in the form of waves. All this we studied. And we studied that in many activities or examples where we understood that the sound is produced in all the cases only when there is vibration present. Only then there is vibration, the sound is produced. So next, we should think that if we humans are able to talk and we are producing sound, means there should be vibration, of course. But where is the vibration taking place is the questions. So our next question is, how does the humans produce sound? That we shall understand. So today's session we shall discuss about the sound produced by the humans. Sound produced by the humans. How we humans produce sound is the next question. Now children, we all know we talk with the help of mouth. When we do so, when you talk or you sing or you scream or you do whatever you want you do, when you are doing so children, just place your hand on the throat like this. On this part of the throat is there, no? There you just touch. You can sense some vibration there. You can sense some vibration or a kind of movement you can sense there. Even when you sing, when you talk or when you shout or when you scream, even just movement of this lower and upper jaws when you do, you can sense some movement children. So when you're talking or when you're singing, if you just hold your hand here and touch it, I can sense something is moving or something is vibrating, some vibration you can sense. What is vibrating here is, you might have heard of the voice box. Voice box. You might have heard people telling, hey, those will scream and talk, those will shout. If they are making noise, your voice box will get damaged. So, talk softly, they will tell. Isn't it? You have heard of it. So, what is this voice box? Is there some box to produce the sound or to produce a vibration inside? So, what is this voice box, means children? What do we have inside here on the, about the windpipe? You know about the windpipe, foot pipe and all. You have studied in biology. So this voice box has one more name. It is also called larynx. L-A-R-Y-N-X. Larynx is also called the voice box, or voice box is also called the larynx, children. So voice box or larynx is present here in this neck part, neck region of our body, which is helping in producing the vibration, This voice box or windpipe is, voice box or the larynx is situated above the windpipe here. You know about the windpipe and the foot pipe. You have learned it in bio class, isn't it children? So, you know what is windpipe. This voice box or larynx is situated above the windpipe. Whenever you talk or sing or make some sound, what actually will happen is this produce the vibration in the throat region of your body, children. You can sense the vibration when you are talking or making some sound. So this larynx or voice box is helping in producing the vibration and in turn production of sound from you. And there are vocal cords. C-O-R-D-S. The vocal cords. There are two vocal cords. There are two vocal cords, which are a thin membrane. There are two vocal cords, which are stretched across this windpipe, across this voice box children. You can see the picture there in the textbook if you want. So there will be two vocal cords which are stretched across the voice box. So whenever, and there is a small gap, you can see here in the picture. I am not drawing it too good. Please understand children. You have it clearly given in your textbook. Voice box madhya enagutte ee vocal cords idyalla adu eradu vocal cords madhya it has opened and there is a gap in between the vocal cords. There is a gap in between the vocal cords. So what will happen is whenever you talk or you sing or you make some sound, you are sucking in the air. So see, immediately if you are sitting, if I hold a talk, how long you can talk, it is very difficult. So you will always suck in the air whenever you are talking. So when you do so children, the air will pass in this gap. The air which is pumped from the lungs also you can say, or when you intake the air, what will happen is the air will travel in between this vocal cords, and it will make the air will make the membrane of these vocal cords to vibrate, or it will make the vocal cords to vibrate. And with the and this vocal cords, you know, they are attached to the voice box, and that in turn will produce the sound, and hence you can sense the vibration when you hold your hand near the throat region. That is what is happening in case of human beings. What we learned today is how is sound produced by the humans. We basically know that sound is produced only when there is vibration of the objects. So what is vibrating here means we have something called voice box or the larynx in the throat region of our body. So this voice box or the larynx is situated upon the windpipe. Why? Because air should pass. No, it should not be situated on the foot pipe. It should be situated on the windpipe. So it is situated above the windpipe. Next, there are two vocal cords in our throat region, which is stretched across the larynx or the voice box. Whenever we intake the air to make some sound, the air will, and there is gap in between the vocal cords. Whenever we make some sound, the air is traveling or passing in between those vocal cords, and in turn results in vibration of the vocal cords, which is helping in production of sound. That is how the sound is produced by the humans. Next children, to understand one more thing is this voice box or the vocal cords, what we said, the length of the vocal cord varies. Have you ever thought? Length of the vocal cords varies. How does it vary? For some it may be longer, for some it may be shorter. Usually they say children, for men or for the gents, the length of this vocal cords is more compared to the ladies or the women. Compared to women, the length of the vocal cords of men is longer. So when you talk or when you speak, there is, you can note the difference who is talking, when a man or a woman is speaking, you can easily make out. How does that sound vary? Even in case of kids, you can make out whether the elderly person is talking or the kid is talking. How can you make out? In case of kids, children, the length of the the voice box or the vocal cords is very small. As and when you grow up, the length of the vocal cords also go on growing along with you. So what actually is happening is the length of the vocal cord will vary. For gents it will be longer, or for men it will be longer compared to the length of the vocal cord of women. That is the reason there is variation in the sound produced by your father or your mother, maybe your younger brother or sister, or in compared to your voice, there is some variation. That variation in your voice is due to the length of the vocal cords, varying length of the vocal cords. This is very important thing, children. Sometimes this vocal cords, I said there is gap between the vocal cords in this in our throat region. This vocal cords sometimes can be too tight or it can be loose as well. In both the cases, there is of course the sound produced. So to understand that concept, andre vocal cords are membrane, when it will be tight, when it will be loose, anta they have given one beautiful activity. What is that, children? You might have played this during your childhood. Take the two rubber band, thin membranes of rubber band, just make a hole, and this pass the air or you just talk, you can hear the sound produced. Take the thin rubber bands and place it one upon the other, and in the space in between them just talk or make some sound, you can hear it. And one more example, this is in case of larynx, well, or not vocal cords, which have tight thick membranes. When it is loose, what will happen is, one more is, take just a small piece of paper, you take, make a slit. Slit means a hole you make in center of it. Just fold it, you can sheet centrally hole maadi, then cover it, make it fold it, and then just blow or do something. You can hear the sound. So in that case, the membrane were very closer in case of rubber band, but here it is loose, children. It is little looser compared to the first one, which was thicker. So like this, the vocal cord will work. In both, sometimes some cases it will be tightened, some cases it will be loosened. In both the cases, the sound will be produced, and this also results in the variation of the sound. This also results in variation of the sound. This is about the sound produced in human. Humans have the voice box or the larynx, which is helping in production of sound. This larynx or windpipe is situated, larynx or the voice box is situated upon the windpipe, and there are two vocal cords which are present, and it is attached to the, or it is stretched towards these larynx, and there is a gap in between the vocal cords. Whenever we talk or make some sound, we let in the air, the lungs will pass the air through it, and it in turn vibrates the vocal cords, and hence the sound can be produced. How can you sense this? Means just by holding your hand in the throat region when you make some sound. Next, the length of the vocal cord varies from person to person. Usually we talk, it varies from men to women and women to child. The vocal cord of men is longer compared to that of women, and in case of kids, the vocal cord length is too small. As and when the kids grow, the vocal cord length also go on increasing. That is the reason we see variation in that pitch or tone or sound of or voice difference in between the elders and the kids, or maybe the difference in voice of men and women as well. Next is, children, what we studied is, in some cases the vocal cord or that may be tightened or it may be loosened. Best is loosen and not too wide. Comparatively, it will be loosened. To understand that, take a rubber band, stretch the membrane, you take one upon the other, and in the small gap, just blow it, and you can hear the sound produced. Again, one more piece of paper you take, make a slit or a hole in the center, just fold it half and blow, you can still hear the sound. In both the cases, you can note the difference in the sound produced, children. So, this is how the sound is produced by the vocal cords, when it is tightened or when it is loosened. So this is all about the sound produced by human. So after knowing what is sound, how it travels, what are the various musical instruments or sources of sound, how it is produced in each case, about and how sound is produced by humans, after understanding all this, next question is, does sound require a medium for its propagation?